हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई पीनल परमार वेलकम्स यू ऑल टू द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ सेंट थॉमस स्कूल। टुडे वी विल सी इंग्लिश ऑफ क्लास 7th, यूनिट 1, एक्सप्लोरिंग सिंबल्स। स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस फर्स्ट सी व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ एक्सप्लोर। एक्सप्लोर मीन्स टू सर्च समथिंग, टू डिस्कवर समथिंग, एंड सिंबल मीन्स साइन और लोगो ऑफ समथिंग। लाइक अ स्कूल हैज सिंबल ऑफ डीपर, ब्रॉडर, हायर। लाइक फॉर ओलंपिक्स ऑल्सो फायरिंग लोगो इज देयर। नाउ लेट अस सी एक्टिविटी 1। हियर वी विल सी अबाउट रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर। रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर वॉज बॉर्न इन कलकत्ता इन 1861। He is the poet who wrote India's national anthem, and he won a Nobel Prize in Literature in 1913. Tagore started to write poetry when he was only 8 years old, and he published his first poem when he was only 16. For this first poem, Tagore did not use his real name. He used a pen name. His pen name in English meant Sun Lion. Dear children, we know that Rabindranath Tagore was a great poet, and he has composed our national anthem Janaganamana. As we have seen, he has also won the Nobel Prize in Literature. At the very young age of 16, he started writing the poetry. And he published his first poetry. He did not use his real name. He used his pen name. We know, students, that some writers, they don't want to reveal their real name. So they use another name for publishing their books. Like writer William Sidney Potter, he used O. Henry as his pen name. Like one Gujarati writer, Gauri Shankar Joshi, he used Dhoomketu as his pen name. So like that, here Rabindranath Tagore also used his pen name, which is called in English Sun Lion, which is called in Hindi Bhanu Sinha. So children, guess that if you want to publish a story or a poem, what pen name would you like to choose? So here in a textbook, one box is given. So if you choose your pen name for writing a story or a poem, your name can be as silly or as serious as you wish. What you have to do? You have to write that pen name which you choose. You have to write it here. So students, now let us move to activity 2. First of all, I will read this poem and then I will explain you. Where the mind is without fear, this poem is written by Rabindranath Tagore. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where the knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls, where the words come out from the depth of the truth, where the tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert sand of dead habit, where the mind is led forward by thee into ever-widening thought and action, into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. In this poem, the poet expressing his views that the people of the country live without any fear. Their head is held high, means their head is stood high with a proud, with a dignity. Where the knowledge is free, means where the education is free without any discrimination, without any differences. The poet says, where the world has not been broken up into fragments, means the world is not divided into the caste, religion, region, There is no domestic wall, narrow domestic walls, means casteism, regionalism, etc. Where the tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection. The poet says that the people work hard, they stretch their hand toward the perfection. Where the words come out from the depth of the truth, means whatever work they do, that should be come out from the truthful, from the truth. Where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert sand of dead habit. Means we, the people of the country, should not lost into the casteism, into the blind belief, into the superstitious, dairy desert. Here dairy desert means the dead beliefs, the blind belief, superstitious. From all these aspects we have to come out. We should not lost in all these vices. Where the mind is led forward by thee into ever widening thought and action. Means people's mind should be led forward. Freedom of mind. There is the expression of ideas, thoughts. The people express their thoughts. Widening. Openly they express their thoughts. Into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. Here, the poet praying to God, he urges to God that my country, the people of my country, should come out from the casteism, creed, superstitious belief. The poet asks God that my country awake. The people of the country should be free. Their head is high, free. They are not under any slavery. Their knowledge, their education is free. That the poet Rabindranath Tagore wants to say through this poem. He urges to God, he prays to God about the people of our country. They should be come out from all these superstitious beliefs, blind beliefs and all. So dear children, here I'll give you some homework. Your homework is, you have to read this poem again. You have to find the new words, hard words, and which you have to write it in the box below. In the textbook, the box is given. There you have to write the new words, hard words for you. And you have to find the meaning of that words. You can use a dictionary or internet and you can find the meaning. Then we will see further. So here we will end up this session. Thank you.